So in our previous discussion, we have learned about the uses and different types of soil, the importance of soil. Soil is an important natural resource. We depend on soil for food, clothing, shelter, lot of minerals and fuels can be obtained from soil. For underground water also we depend upon soil. So today we will be learning some more properties of soil, that is, first is water percolation in the soil. What does this term mean? So the percolation is the water which is getting seeped in the different layers of the soil, the water which is getting absorbed by the soil. So to calculate how much water has been percolated or how much water has moved down the different layers of soil in a given amount of time is called as rate of percolation. So the percolation rate is the amount of water absorbed by any soil at any given time. So this percolation rate is going to be different for different types of soil. This can be calculated by using the given formula, that is, percolation rate in milliliters per minute is equal to amount of water in milliliters divided by percolation time given in minutes. So the value can be calculated by putting these in this formula. Second is absorption of water by the soil. How much water is going to be absorbed by a given sample of soil? So let's say U is the initial volume, that is the initial volume of water which we have taken for the experiment. V is the final volume which is left after the experiment. So what you have taken and what is left, if you subtract these both the terms, what you are going to get is amount of water absorbed by the soil. So which can be given by U minus V? U is initial volume, V is the final volume. Divided by 50. 50 here is the 50 grams of soil taken in the process. Multiplied by 100 will give you the percentage of water absorbed. It can be solved by using this given formula. Next is soil erosion. Soil erosion is the removal of the top layer of the soil. Now the top layer of the soil removal means, because as we have studied earlier, top soil is the most fertile layer of the soil. So if this is removed, that means the soil quality is going to be decreased. Soil erosion is caused by natural processes like water flowing or wind blowing. So these are the two natural processes that can cause soil erosion. There are many human activities that can also cause soil erosion. Overcropping, overgrazing and deforestation. So if I talk of natural processes, continuous flow of water over a surface of the soil can lead to the removal of top layer. And if the strong winds are blowing, they can also take away the soil, top layer of the soil along with them. Next is by human activities like overcropping. Again and again, that same piece of land is being cropped. Again and again, that same piece of land is being used for grazing of cattle. So this is going to deplete the quality of the soil. This is going to remove, loosen the top layer of the soil. Deforestation is cutting down of the trees on a large scale, because the roots of the trees, they bind the soil together and they do not let the soil flow along with water or wind. So if we are going to do deforestation, that will contribute to soil erosion. Next is soil conservation. Soil conservation is how to protect the soil from being eroded. So it is the prevention of loss of the most topmost layer of the soil from erosion. It could be done by reverse of deforestation, that is afforestation, by planting more and more trees. Along the hill slopes, along the slopy areas of the hills, contour farming and terrace farming could be done. Because whenever there are rains, the water is flowing at a high speed on the slopes, it also takes away a lot of soil with it. So if we are doing contour farming or terrace farming on the hilly slopy areas, it will help us in conserving the soil. Here you can see conservation versus erosion. This slide is showing you that more is the vegetation in the soil, more are the plants present there, it will allow more of the moisture to be absorbed by the soil. So more soil nutrients will be retained there. And in comparison, if a soil is there with no vegetative cover, when the rain will come, winds are blowing, then it will lead to the erosion of the soil. So this is how plants contribute towards soil conservation also and maintaining the level of the underground water as well. Now it's soil pollution. What is soil pollution? When the soil is getting contaminated, how? It could be done by industrial waste, when the chemicals are being thrown directly into a land, bad soil management, fuel leakage. Soil pollution is when we are increasing the chemical components in the soil which are not required. If the pesticides, insecticides are there, if they are being discarded into the soil directly, any chemical is discarded, it is going to cause an impact on the quality of the soil. It is going to cause an impact on the organisms living in the soil. What effect soil pollution is going to have? It will decrease the soil fertility, it will lead to soil erosion, and it can cause toxic dust because the soil is getting contaminated, and if the dust is flowing, it is getting toxic. So today we have learned about the two different properties of soil, that is rate of percolation and rate of water absorption, the percentage of water absorbed by the soil. Next we studied about soil erosion and the measures to conserve the soil. So soil erosion is removal of the top layer of the soil, and conservation is how to protect this top layer of the soil by the process of afforestation, contour farming, terrace farming. Then we learned what are the different causes of soil pollution and what are the effects they are going to have, because if the soil is polluted, the plants will not be able to grow and the organisms will not be able to survive. So we should be more careful and we should spread awareness in our surroundings to stop this ongoing pollution. Thank you.